I am going to try to keep this short and sweet, like me, but I will probably fail miserably. So to be on the safe side, grab a drink and a snack. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45. I needed to think. I'm from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I am going over the products that I got in February and I'm giving you my final opinion. I kind of hope that I have it in the same order that I had it in the whole video, so I can just copy paste the description box. I have done videos with a ton of the goodies here that I will mention, so the ones that I did a video on, I will refer you to the video, because it's otherwise the video will be just way too long. Let's start with what I have on my eyeballs. On my eyeballs is Glam Shop Poland. And let me show you the palette, because it's the peach palette, or at least that's what I think it is. That's what I think, yeah. It's called Morelova, I believe. But I don't really speak Polish. Here's the color story. Yes, the video is either up or it is coming very, very soon. So if you want to know my thoughts on this palette and want to know about the other palette that I got from them, because I got two palettes, they are not in this video. They are going to be in the whole video for March. Make sure that you are subscribed and have hit the bell button so you will be notified when they go online. And if you haven't subscribed yet, just do so, because I am so much fun. I love colorful makeup, but I also love neutral makeup. I have a lot of indie brands and I am finding more and more indie brands, especially European indie brands. But I'm just so sweet and cute and fun and weird. Never mind. And apparently soothing. Let's start with stuff that I hold. What was it? I don't know. I ordered it last year and it came this year. It was lost in the mail, which is from AOA Studios. Let's go over it very, very quickly. I ordered a bunch of blushes, or I ordered two cream blushes and a cream highlighter. No, that's different. I like the formula of the cream blushes. I do want to set them and I use them with a brush. That is it. You can build them up. You can shear them out. If I use the butt of a sponge, it gets patchy on me very, very quickly. This is the only shade that I have used so far, which is the shade Merlot, which is very complimentary for me. The other shade is the shade... Oh, Bloom. I always... Which is more... more hot pink. So maybe more along the lines of summer. I haven't used this one yet. I haven't opened it. The highlighter I have in the shade Dream. It's a nice color. I actually tried to put it on top of powder and that works very, very well. Now, I tend to use this one with a finger. I do need to make sure that I don't use too much in one go, that I basically go in lightly and build up. Because if I use too much in one go, it has a tendency to lift off my foundation. But I have to say that this is kind of a problem area usually for foundation sticking anyway, if I have not prepped correctly. So yeah, this one I haven't used. I really like the formula. I think that if you see these and you like the colors, just go get them, because they're cheap as chips and very much worth it. I also got a glitter primer that I haven't tried yet, but I do want to. I am, however, experimenting between not using a glitter primer and using a glitter primer. So I want to test this out against a non-glitter primered eye as well, and also against the NYX glitter primer, but I haven't yet. I will. But I haven't. This one is the Glow Base. This one was ordered by mistake. I wanted to order the normal eye base. And I actually thought that this was a shimmer primer. I don't know why. Probably because it said Glow Base. And I just did not read the very big lettering here. Light Gold Shimmer. So I will just give this to someone who will use it. Because I won't use this. I have enough eyeshadow primers as it is. I don't need to be breaking open one that I know I will not use. Because I don't do matte looks often anyway. And if I do a matte look, it is because I want to have a matte look. Does that make any sense? So yeah. Then I ordered the backup of my Shelby Falsies. Yeah, these are very dramatic, but so, so comfortable. They are not heavy, or at least for me, they're not. The band is stiff enough to hold the falsie, and it is flexible enough to shape to my eye without my eyelid going like that. You know, sometimes that happens, that your eyelid is being... Yes, that's it. I really like them, and I like I do like the quality of the AOA Studio Falsies anyway. Definitely worth it. So, okay. Then I got the Naked Kitty Cat palette from Sigil Inspired. Yeah, if you have followed me and seen more of my videos, you know I love this palette with a passion. If you love the color story, it's definitely worth it. I did a video, two looks and then a review, and I will refer you to that video if you want to know more thoughts. The next thing that I ordered that came in this month is my Kaleidos order. I ordered the Ray Rider highlighter, which is, if you don't know, I am a light olive. Yeah, light medium olive. Basically, probably medium or middle, whatever, in summer. This is such a pretty complementary shade for me. So if you are light olive, this is a very pretty shade for you as well. I am warm olive though. This is so pretty. I love the component. I love the formula. I understand why people rave about this. I picked this one because I thought it would be the one that I would use the most. That is it. The Mars one, is very, very interesting as well. I just don't know if it will complement my skin tone and if I will use it. So if you have the Mars one, you know, the red pinker one, and you are an olive, let me know how it is. Then I also got a contour palette because I really wanted to try it. This is the shade Warm Medium. I like the formula. I like the weight of it as well. I like the formula. The contour shade is nice for me. I do have to say though that I prefer a cream contour. So if this was a cream, I would have used the crepe tone, but it's not. It's a powder, and a lot of the time I just forget to grab a powder contour. The bronzer is a very light bronzer, a bronzer that you can sheer out if you wanted to just get a hint of warmth. You can build it up as well. It is a little bit on the redder side, I almost feel, when I put it on. I know that in the video where I tried it, I got the comments that it was almost non-existent, at least on camera. And I agree. When I saw back the footage, I saw that as well. But when I looked in the mirror or outside, I could see it. And it was a very nice, subtle bronzer that I will use probably more in winter than in summer, because I do really like the formula. And yeah, I like the fact that it just feels luxurious and high-end because it's so weighted, you know. Then the pièce de résistance is this one, the Club Nebula palette. Yeah, I did a video, Get Ready With Me, because I was not going to do a multiple looks video. And in that video, I felt some shades and I was like, yeah, I don't care who watches the video. I'm going to do a three looks video, and I did. And it is online as well, and I will link it. It will also be in the description box. Yeah, guys, she just did amazingly. This is the Club Nebula palette in collaboration with Angelica. This is just... it should be permanent, not gonna lie. The quality is so, so good. This is the quality that I hope to see from Kaleidos from now on. I know Angelica does not use a glitter primer, and I can tell because these shimmers stay on perfectly on older eyes, on eyes with folds, without a glitter primer. They are maybe a little bit more of topper shades, but if you spray your brush, you can get them opaque. Yeah. Then the next thing that I hold, which is then basically February, is the Norns collection from Odin's Eye. I'm going to go a little bit more or talk about this a little bit longer, because I have not done dedicated videos on this, and I will not, because that's not why I got the collection. I got this collection because of the theme. To be honest, the thing that I wanted from the collection was this palette, Urd, which is the oldest sister of the Norns. And the Norns are, in a nutshell, past, present, future. It's very, very condensed. But here is this color story, and I think this is almost everyone's favorite. The color story is so, so good. The shimmers are interesting. They are gorgeous, but the formula is... it is maybe a little bit harder to pick up with a brush sometimes. I want to build it up. And I actually don't want a glitter primer underneath these as well. They feel like they already have kind of a primer in them. It's very unique. The mattes are gorgeous. Maybe not the easiest to work with. They are not hard to work with, not difficult to work with, especially the palette that I'm mentioning now, the Oort. But because of the darkness and the tone, they are a little bit more of a stiffer formula almost compared to the rest of their palettes, if that makes any sense. I am not the person to ask if it is worth your money, truly, because that is, again, not why I bought the collection. In my mind, it is worth it. Even if the formula had been shit, the collection would have been worth it for me. This was a Verdandi. Then we are going to go to Sculpt. And Verdandi is the middle sister, which Oort spins the threads. Verdandi weaves the web of life. And Sculpt cuts the threads when it is your time. And this is an all shimmer palette. So yeah. I really do like the formula, but again, I'm not the person to ask if it is worth it, because it was worth it for me, so yeah. This is the big palette that I need to play with more in this bottom row. Oh my freaking lord, they're so pretty. So, so pretty. I want to use this one more as well, because I want to use more of the shades. I don't know if I will, or if I will do on camera. That's a better explanation. Then I got one of their Mesmerizer highlights. This is the Web of Destiny. This is what she looks like. I love the way that this looks. I used it once. It's not my preferred formula at all. I found it pretty hard to pick up with the brush that I wanted. I needed to dig my brush in and I did not want it. Maybe it's because I swatched it that it got hard pan or something. It's also a very glittery formula and that's not what I like. The color was also a hint to pink on me, but it doesn't matter because that's not why I bought it, you know? So, yeah. I do like it and I think it is worth its money formula-wise. But yeah, maybe I'm biased. I don't know. But I do truly like it. And I still hope to be on their PR list one day. I'm just going to throw it out there in the universe again. So yeah, the next two palettes that I'm going to show you are from Douglas. Let's start with the Interstellar Smoky, which is this one. And I did videos with these two. So I'm just going to quickly show them to you. So here's the Interstellar Smoky, which is very, very pretty. If you want to know in-depth thoughts, go watch the video. Suffice it to say, I like this color story better than the next one that I'm going to mention. And I also think that it is a little bit easier to work with. So here is the Miami Fever. And they come with a brush, which is nice. So yeah, again, if you want to know my thoughts, go watch the videos. Go watch them anyway if you're interested in these palettes, because they kind of have a little bit of a, I almost want to say learning curve. And in the videos, I give you some tricks and tips to work with shadows like that. So definitely worth checking out. So I also have, two eyeshadow palettes left. If I can open this one, because I should have come more prepared, but I didn't. So I ordered one of the newer small palettes from Makeup Obsession, the Berry Cute palette. This is one of their small 9 pans. I really like these small 9 pan palettes. Let's go there. I haven't used it yet, though. When I got these a few days later, I swapped Beauty Room, so I didn't film a few days, so basically I am way behind. So I haven't touched this one yet, but I do really want to. I like the color story in here. And of the palettes that I have from them, I really like the formula as well. The only tip I have though is don't swatch them, because you basically get hard pan really, really quickly. Because the pans are tiny, you need to dig your fingers in, yes. Then Essence released two new palettes, two out in the wild, or at least I think they are called that. There's a pink one and the green one, but the green one is neutral. Only the outer packaging is green. This is one called Don't Stop Blooming. I haven't used this one either, but it does look very pretty. That's why I got this one. I'm very curious to see how... Why are you... Thank you. I'm very curious to see about the formula though. But yeah, I haven't had time yet to play with those. Then I got two lashes, because Essence released new lash styles. Guys, these lashes, when I saw them, I was like, wow, Essence, what have you done? Are you okay? These are so dramatic, especially for Essence, because a lot of the time when a drugstore brand says we have dramatic falsies, I'm like, yeah, they are my natural style. I don't have these on today, but I've been using these a crap ton. This one, this style is called Oh My God. which is a little bit more dense and a little bit more dramatic than the other style that I have here, which is the style Unique, which is more open. And they are pretty long, but they are very complimentary, at least for me. And truly, I have been using them a crap ton. They are so, so good. And they are, even though they are more dramatic falsies, the bands are so nice and flexible. Yeah, they're like no other falsies I have ever tried. They're definitely, definitely worth it. Now, I haven't seen these in stores yet. I also don't know if they are permanent. So I bought mine at Boozy Shop and I'm kind of looking to see to stock up on them because they are just so, so good. I should not do that, but yeah, I know that I will. Not gonna lie. Then I'm going to mention the NYX Epic Ink Wear. Epic Wear Ink. What is it? The Epic Wear Liner Stick in Orange Zest. Yeah, this is so pretty. It's such a pretty color and it stays on all day. It's very, very pretty. I could have used it in the look today. I didn't, but I could have. Definitely, definitely worth it. Then, oh yeah, stays all day. Did I say that? I think I did. Then I ordered the Natasha Denona Eye Base in the shade Medium. I have tried this with a bunch of eyeshadow formulas. So far, yeah, it has worked with them all. So, yeah, that's it. When I put it on, it looks very, very dark and too dark for me. But when I tap it out, it almost melts into my skin. Depth-wise, not tone-wise, but depth-wise. And yeah, the shadows perform very, very well on top of it. I do want to see about the light one day, but not on full price. Because yeah, this one worked for me in winter as well. But I am kind of curious to see the difference. Because I feel like I could compare the light one best to the one from ABH. Because of the, yeah, the fact that this is... yeah, the ABH is so light. That was what I wanted to say. And then let's go then to the Guilty Cosmetics Brow Jam. Yeah, do I need to say more? She released a bumblebee and I needed a bumblebee. Yeah, this is a little bit more sticky than the other one that I have. And sticky, it almost feels like there is honey in this. I don't know if there is, but it almost feels like it. Yeah, I like it. I have been using this with a dry spoolie, same with the Cotton Candy. I do feel though that the Cotton Candy picks up better dry with a spoolie than this one. I feel like I have to dig my spoolie into this one a little bit more, so I sprayed it in the hope that it kind of softens up a little bit more. But yeah, what can I say? Guilty Cosmetics is a UK-based indie brand. It is just amazeballs. So yeah, then I ordered a bunch of foundations. I have not done dedicated videos on these foundations. Let me know if you want me to, though. Let's start with EX1. So for EX1, the shade I ordered was shade 3, I believe, because that is what they recommended on the website, which was way too neutral for me, so it made my face turn pink again. So yeah, so I ordered a few other shades. I ordered the lightest one in the hopes that it would be, I don't know, olive enough that I could kind of combat that pinkiness a little bit more. It's not. It's very pale, which isn't bad because I like to have a very pale shade of foundation so I can lighten up the foundation that I'm working with of the same line. Then according to a site that I found the shade matches on, shade 4 was fair olive, warm olive, and shade 5 was light olive. But that's not completely true now, is it? This is a warm olive and this is almost a neutral olive. That's how I see them. This is too dark for me, but I can lighten it up with the shade 1. This one is still closed because I prefer this one a little bit more, I feel. Or not. Well, maybe this one is even better. I don't know. I tried this one and I lightened it up and it worked. However, foundation-wise, it is not my most favorite. It is a very matte foundation. I think I will like this in summer though, when my face is a little bit more oily because of the sweatiness, because of the warm weather. So I will keep on trying this. For winter, it's a little bit too matte for me, for my liking. Even with a hydrating primer underneath. It's a very full coverage foundation if you want to though. But yeah, this is not fair, people. So there's a very big gap between... Yeah, the weird thing is they are being marketed as the olive undertone. That is what they say on Beauty Bay, foundation with an olive undertone. But that's not true. So it's very confusing for me. Hence the fact that I have three, which I don't really like. But yeah, it is what it is. It's not a bad foundation. I think that if you are oily, you will like it. For me, again, I'm going to reserve judgment until the summer. And then the Urban Decay Stay Naked in the shade 30CG. I thought it was too cool for me, but it was just too light and yellow, almost. I don't know. It looked a little bit ashy on me. But yeah, when I darkened it up with a concealer that I will mention a little bit later, it was very pretty. So then I saw it was basically just a little bit too light. So I actually ordered the darker shade, which is 50CG. Can you tell that? I wish there was a shade in between, because that's basically what I need. But yeah, this one was on sale. This one was also on sale. So yeah, I got a good deal. And I do truly, truly like the foundation. Again, if you want me to do a dedicated video with wear time and all that, I can. I really do like it. It feels weightless. It's very, very pretty. Yeah, it's just, yeah, I have to mix. But yeah, then again, I mix almost everything today. So yeah, I really like the foundation. Then let's go to Fenty, the Pro Filter foundation. I have the shade 145, which is their lightest olive, and then I have 290, which is then basically the one olive up. I mix the two together right now. This is perfect for me in the depth of winter. When I get a tiny bit more dark, it almost oxidizes to my skin tone, which is very nice because it can oxidize a hint. And now I mix in a little bit of the darker one. I really do like the foundation a lot. I keep on reaching for it over and over and over again. I do have to say, I am going to show you the primer that I use underneath, and that is this one, the Hydro Primer from Catrice. I want a hydrating primer underneath that has a little bit of substance, because it gives me more time to work with the foundation. And yeah, I just like this one the best. I could use the one from AOA Studio, which is also more of a creamier one, almost. And yeah, this is perfect, or I feel at least, underneath this foundation. And then I don't have to set it. It's not overly matte. It's not as matte as the EX1, and I tried it with this this one as well. I think it's just a gorgeous foundation, and that's it. I think it's a gorgeous foundation, and I get why these two foundations in particular that I mentioned are more expensive, because I can really tell the difference, especially if I then compare this foundation, which is basically a matte foundation, to this foundation, which is also a matte foundation, or maybe even natural satin foundations. This is way, way better, truly. I also got the concealers to match. Yeah, the one from 4-5 concealer is, can you tell how light it is? It's so, so light. It's just insane. It is almost, yeah, I think it's 2 shades lighter than the foundation. So maybe that will help you. I did not know that, so it scared me a lot when I first tried it, because it's way too light for me. But I mix it with this one, so I do a dot of this and then I do a dot of this, and then it is okay. This is the shade 290, which is a tad too dark for me right now, but probably in summer it's the perfect color to use as a concealer. I like the consistency of it as well. I like the fact that I don't need a lot. I like that it sets on its own. I do want to set it. I do set it with skin finish like powder. So I set it with my Kiko Milano Waterflower Magic Powder that has a tiny bit of a sheen in it, because I find that prettiest to do. Yes, that is it. I find that prettiest to do. Okay, let's next go to a bunch of concealers. The reason that I got these is because I wanted to try an olive concealer, and I wanted a cheap option. That is why I ordered a bunch from Makeup Revolution. This is the shade 5.7, which is a very, very nice shade match for me concealer wise. It's a tad light, but I can still make it. It's not as light as the Fenty one, but I can still make it work. Yeah, it's their lightest olive 5.7. I also, because this one dries down on its own as well, dries down matte, this is also one that I set with that Kiko powder, because it has a hint of a sheen. Then I got 2 colors, because I wanted contour and bronzer, and I was just kind of trying stuff out. This is 11.2, which is too yellow to use right now, at least as a contour or a bronzer, but I can use this to darken up an olive foundation that is too light. I can really nicely use this one for that. This shade 11.5 I can use as a bronzer shade if I want to. I could theoretically use it as a contour as well, but I like it, the shade, as a bronzer. I just don't really like to use a product like this as a bronzer, I have found out. I like sticks better. But I do know that there are a lot of people who like to use this one. The nice thing about something like this is these dry down on their own, so you don't have to set them necessarily with powder. There is that. Okay, then I got from Juvia's Place a foundation stick in the shade Yakmel, which is, yeah, it's too light. Oh no, too yellow. I don't really know what to use this for. It is pretty... Yeah, I want to say yellow. It's not, but it's maybe too warm, but not dark enough to use for me as a bronzer. I can make it work, but I don't know. I kind of find it a little bit of a wonky color. I do like the consistency of this though. So this was just basically, I like the formula, but I don't really like the color just yet. Maybe I like it in summer a little bit more. I don't know. It's just not it, you know? I think I need a few shades darker for to be able to use it as a bronzer. And maybe a little bit cooler if I want to use it as a contour. And then I got the NYX Wonder Stick in medium tan. I actually think that Alexandra has light medium. Why do I have medium tan? I have this on today as bronzer slash contour. It's maybe a little bit too reddish for me. I can make it work though. I actually thought that she got the medium tan, but maybe the light medium highlighter and contour stick. This is what I use right now a lot of the time for contour and bronzer. And the reason that I got this is because Alexandra, I'm going to say Anele, because I like that sound better. I don't know if it's correct though. She's basically my go-to for stuff like this, because she also is a fair to light olive, warm olive. So basically what works for her should kind of, I hope at least, work for me. And she used the NYX Wonder Stick as a drugstore option. But the last time I heard her mention light medium. And I have medium tan. So maybe I need to see the light medium one as well. Yes. Then I have a skincare. Let's see. The Inky List Peptide Moisturizer Cream. Yeah, it is, I think, top number. Was it top number two? I like the cream a lot. Yes, then what did I also have? Oh yeah, the Mario Badescu Hyaluronic Acid Eye Cream. It's top number three. Does that say enough? I really, really like that eye cream. I also got the Mario Badescu Makeup Remover Cream. Yeah, I don't think I really like that one. I have it upstairs now in the bathroom. I don't know, it removes makeup, but I don't really... I kind of want to wash my face after. Again, so yeah, it's not really, I have it as a backup, but that's what I use it for. But because I did not really like that one, I ordered the W7, what is it, peach makeup remover balm. Yeah, that one is bombdiggity.com. I ordered it from Boozy Shop. It's around €5. It's cheap as chips, and it is such a nice balm to oil. Oh, and I love that. And it melts off my makeup. It smells amazingly. I need more. That's it. Yeah. And then I got some PR from Madage Beauty London. They are a new brand. They are based, the site that I can order from is based in the UK, but they ship from Canada. And they have their own brand, but they are also a reseller site. Oh yeah, basically. So they have a bunch of very, very cool products, very cool brands there as well. Go check them out. And they are killing it, because they are releasing a ton right now. But they sent me the Sakura Romance, or part of the Sakura Romance collection in PR to try. I also have a code with them that will be listed down below. I did a dedicated video on it, so if you want to know my thoughts, I will refer you to the video. Let me just show you the colors. This is the blush in Sakura, which is too blue for me. Not gonna lie. I can make it work, but for what I prefer, the shade is not what I go for. I do really like the formula though. And these are the two eyeshadow shades. So this is the shade called Peace, and this is the shade called Love. They are very, very nice. I do have to be honest and say that... after the video that I did with these, I haven't touched them because there was so much to get through, and I did not have enough time, truly. So they also sent me the, what is it called? The Mad Azur Lash Mascara. I think it's a volumizing one, but I actually don't know, in black. This is the wand, and I really, really do like the wand. This is a water-resistant mascara. I don't really use this with my falsies, because if I am wearing falsies, I want a tube mascara. However, if I'm not wearing falsies, this holds a curl very, very nicely, and it is a very nice waterproof mascara. Yeah, that's it. If it would have been a tube mascara, it would have been my favorite. Truly. Okay, they also sent me two lippies. The shade, this is Carnation, and I have Tsubaki. So Carnation is this one. It's a hot pink with a sparkly shimmery goodness in it. And I will love this in summer. And the formula is very, very nice. And this is then the other shade. Tsubaki was what I said, right? Let me swatch them so that you can see the colors. And I like the fact that they have kind of a sparkle in them. But it's not... You can see it, but it is not like there is glitter. And it's almost, yeah, this one, the hot pink, almost has a bluish shift. And this one also almost seems to have, I don't know, a golden shift. Or maybe that's my hand, I don't know. I really do like the formula. They have a bunch of colors. And they are coming out with liquid lipsticks and such as well. They are coming out with loads. So yeah, guys, that was it for today. I hope it was a little bit shorter than the whole video. I don't think it was shorter by much, though, not gonna lie. I try to keep it short. But yeah, if you want to know more about the things that I mentioned, check out the description box first for all the videos that are linked there. If there is not a video or the information isn't sufficient, let me know. And let me know if you want me to do dedicated reviews on the foundations that I have mentioned. And let me know if you want me to do... Well, if, yeah, how badly you want to see these two eyeshadow palettes. Videos on these are coming. I just don't really know when. But if a lot of you say, we want to see them, we want to see them, I will bump them up in the filming schedule. Does that make sense? Yes, it should. That was it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. Yes. And then that is it. Thank you so much for watching. If you have made it this far, leave me an olive emoji because of the foundations. Yes. And give the video a thumbs up if you haven't done so already, of course. And leave me a comment down below because it helps me out tremendously. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.